Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. My name is Edwin Hernandez, Grasshopper Specialist at Shape Diver. In today's video, we will explain why to avoid simplifying data trees to prevent the loss of crucial information that keeps your data structured. This is particularly important if you are working on definitions that work with one or multiple items and when merging different streams of data. But before we get started, please remember to subscribe and to like this video as it really helps our channel. And if you haven't done so already, follow us on all of our different social media channels. If you want to know more about what you can do with Shape Diver, make sure to check out our website. And please remember that all the relevant links and files shown in this video will be down in the description. All right, let's get started. So here we are in the Grasshopper canvas. As you know, everything in Grasshopper gets stored in data trees. The purpose of this tutorial is not to explain data trees. However, we need to explain how the data flows to Grasshopper so that we can understand why to avoid simplifying our data trees. So here we have a single rectangle, which gets stored in the branch 0, which contains, of course, just a single item. So as you can see, even though we have a single item, this item is still contained inside a data tree. So if we check our diagram, of course, it's a very simple data tree diagram where we have a single branch. Now, what happens if instead of giving one single item as input, we give a list of items? So we still get a single branch, but this branch now contains 4 items and our data tree diagram looks the same. Now, if we graph our tree, this will put each of our items in different branches. So if we check, we can see that now our tree has 4 branches, each of them with 1 item. And if we see the paths of our branches, we can see that all of them start by 0, which is the original branch path of our group. So by keeping this number 0 at the beginning of our branch paths, Grasshopper is telling us that these items, these new items that were created in these new branches, all come from the same origin group. So from the same 0 group. However, what happens if we know that our 0 group will be always the same? So we know that this will never change, therefore it becomes irrelevant to store the information of our group number 0. So we can simplify our tree. And what this will do is to get rid of all the irrelevant paths in our tree. So in this case, because all the first index is the same, it gets deleted. And then when we check our diagram, we have lost here the information that all of our branches actually come from the same origin. Now, this is okay if you know that your original data is always a list. Because what happens if we don't have a list, but we have a single item? So if we go back to a single item, we can see that our simplify didn't get rid of our first index. So it behaved differently. When we gave it a list, it got rid of our first 0. But when we gave it an item, it kept the number 0, even though we wanted to simplify our tree. The reason this happens is because when we have a list of items and then we get different branches, we have a list of paths where we can compare and see which indexes are the same and therefore irrelevant. But if we have a single item, we don't have any branches paths to compare with. Therefore, Grasshopper doesn't know what should be deleted in our data paths. How is this a problem when working with Grasshopper? Let's go back and input our list of sizes. And let's say that we want to offset these rectangles. This will create an additional depth in our tree. So as you can see, now we got an additional 0 at the end of our tree. Now let's merge the tree with our original rectangles with the tree with our offset rectangles to get groups of 2. So one is the original and the other one is the offset rectangle. So here, as you can see, as output, we are getting a tree with different indexes depths. And that can be solved easily by simplifying our output in our offset component. Then that will give us our four branches with two items per branch. This works if our source data is always a list of items. But what happens if we give it just a single item? Well, as I already explained, the simplified component doesn't have any other branches to compare with, and therefore it doesn't simplify our tree. And then we end up with two branches because Grasshopper never knew what was irrelevant. So if we, for example, want to create a boundary surface between these two rectangles, then we will get an error because both rectangles are not living in the same branch. Again, if we give it a list, then it will work, but if we give it an item, it won't work. So what's the alternative? The alternative is to use other components or data tree operations that Grasshopper offers, like, for example, trimming our tree, or shifting our tree, or even the path mapper. And with these components, we are actually telling Grasshopper exactly what is irrelevant and what is not. So instead of letting Grasshopper decide what's irrelevant, we can tell Grasshopper exactly what is irrelevant. So for example, here we could get rid of this simplify and just use our trim component, because the trim component gets always rid of the last indexes in our paths, depending on the depth we give it. So for example, if we give it here 1, that means that it will get rid of just the last 0 in our path. Then we can input that here, and this will give us the correct result. However, we are still using one simplify component here at the beginning, so we can also get rid of that one and just have the trim operations where they are relevant. So normally tree operations are relevant when you are gonna merge data. So if we now give it a list, we will get a good result, and if we give it an item, we will always also get a good result. And if we still want to get rid of the relevant information, so for example here we still have the group number 0, which is always the same, we can do it, but again using not the simplify component. So if we put a list here, we just need to get rid of the first column of zeros. To do that, we can use the shift component and give it as input in the offset 1. That means that we are trimming our tree paths, but from the beginning. So we get the 0, 1, 2, 3 without the initial index. We can input that in the offset, we can input that in the merge, and then we get again a good result, but now with a very clean tree structure, which doesn't contain any irrelevant paths. So please try to avoid as much as possible the simplify component and just simplify your tree if you are sure that your original data will always have more than one single branch. And that's all for today. I hope this quick tip helps you when working with data trees. And if you like this video, please click the like button down below. And if you don't want to miss the next video, please subscribe. And I will see you in the next tutorial.